pastor. I'm a little confused. I saw something. You're the toast pastor. Who's the John Violator? The gentleman Violator. I just brought that up because, and fellow Toastmasters, I thought it's important to start out talking about what Toastmasters is all about. What differentiates Toastmasters from perhaps other organizations which provide a forum for people to give speeches in? And what it really is, as far as I'm concerned, is that it provides immediate feedback to people who give speeches. Yes, there is unwritten feedback which people are providing. However, what really happens is that from a speaker's perspective, what he or she receives is some immediate feedback. Now, granted, it is the feedbacker's personal opinion. And as a speaker, of course, you want to take something out of that, whether or not you agree or not. But hopefully there's some pearl of wisdom in there which you will find particularly worthwhile. On a personal level, so why I chose this speech, this canned speech, is because I personally have a problem giving evaluations. I am somewhat, my goodness, look at that evaluation. How could they have thought of that sort of thing? In any case, I really hope that this speech will help me personally. And hopefully at the same time will help you give perhaps better evaluations. Let's get going. As I mentioned, provides immediate feedback. This is a time for the speaker to listen to you, giving that evaluation. He or she can sit back and, yes, what pearls of wisdom, what is there in this particular evaluation that allows me perhaps to improve the next time I give an evaluation? This is particularly important. And one thing is that for people embarking on perhaps some pathways or indeed in the traditional Toastmasters syllabus is to give the person a little pat on the back. Some sense, yes, I want to come back and give my next speech. You want them to feel that they are doing something right. Of course, the first thing that people are doing right is to come here. They want to speak. They want to challenge themselves and become better at speaking. It's fundamentally important to make the first step, and that is to come to Toastmasters. However, that is only part of the story. As an evaluator, you can help complete that story by giving them a sense of, yes, you did that really well, whatever that particular thing might be. As somebody giving a speech, you have the stage. It is your chance to say what you want to say and how you want to say it, and try to get a reaction out of the audience that you want to get out of the reaction. That you want to get out of the audience. When you're being evaluated, that, I think, is the perfect time for you to sit back, relax, take your kudos of, and take your honorable seat of listening and having somebody else evaluate how you did. Look at the pros and the cons of that particular speech that you just gave. If I put the evaluator's hat on, again, it is now the time that you want to ensure that when you're going to evaluate somebody, you try to read that manual before you sit there and evaluate the speech. This evening, I was evaluating Laura, and I made the distinct mistake of not having read the particular manual speech that she had to deliver the topic on. And of course, she was very early on in the speech, in the number of people giving speeches, and so I was caught in a situation where I had to do some rapid catch-up. That is the wrong time to do it. Really, if I had done it earlier today, that would have been much better. that you get the opportunity to gauge how I do my evaluation. I'm stumped by this particular, I looked at this phrase, evaluation guidelines. What are they really talking about? I think what they're referring to is that in the traditional manual, for each speech, it gives the objectives. And I think that's what they're referring to. It's perhaps just my bit of a stretch from the word from objectives to guidelines here. It's also important as an evaluator to ask the person who's giving the speech, before giving the speech, is there any particular thing, mannerism, gesture, whatever, or speech, the way of talking, that you as a speaker do and want the evaluator to try to observe. And I think that's something that is perhaps not at all addressed in the objectives of the speech. But it gives the person, given the speech, the opportunity to ask his or her evaluator, this is what I would like you to particularly pick up on. Funny thing is that when you are a speaker, you are probably trying to get across some particular point or points, deliver some call to action, whatever you're trying to accomplish in your speech. You have your own set of goals. When you're evaluating, you also have goals. You have goals, probably, hopefully, anyway, to give an evaluation which has some sort of meaning to the speaker. And when it says, put yourself in the position of the speaker, well, you are. You're giving the speech yourself. And therefore, it's important that you have some points. You have an introduction, a body conclusion, and I like to think a call to action as well at the end of the speech. At least have some message for the audience that they can relate to somehow and get at least some kernel of knowledge from. Take notes. I find this kind of interesting, of course, that take notes that we're referring to is actually writing something down. I think most people today probably are thinking more of a case of putting something on an iPad or a sketchpad or some sort of like some electronic medium. However, I think that particular state might date from when this particular slide was put together. I was rather bewildered by this particular statement here, and that I said, well, yes, part of being Toastmasters is to not use things like filler words, but that's not really the story here. What I think they want you to do is, when you're giving the evaluation, and that hopefully the person that you are giving the evaluation of is listening to you, every word you say, they are probably hanging on. They are intent on, what does this person have to say about my particular speech? How I delivered it, and this sort of thing. Evaluate the speech, not the person. I think that's something that I personally have had an issue with in the past. One time, we had an individual in the club who were here when I gave the last speech, and I referred to a legendary lady, I think it was. And I think this was perhaps a legendary gentleman, but he was legendary for another particular reason, perhaps. And it's not the letter pi, either. But the initials, we'll put into that. And, inside joke, perhaps, but let's not get bogged down on that. And I was in a situation one time where I had to evaluate his speech. It was after a recent incident that this gentleman had challenged the club with. It was very difficult for me to divorce my mind from that challenge and from that predicament and from how we got to set the club on a path to solving it and his speech. To this day, I don't know if I managed that. However, he did give me some room for some gracious comment to me after I gave the evaluation. So I must have done okay. However, it was very difficult for me to try to make that distinction between what the individual meant to me on a quasi-professional basis and from his speech. A long way to say, listen to the speech, read the objectives, and evaluate the speech against those objectives, and perhaps what the person asked you to do, it also do. I think we've talked about this before, promoting self-esteem. Make sure that you bring out some good points of what the person's speech said in their speech. I'll read that quote. Honest evaluations are upbeat and encouraging while offering suggestions for improvement. We are all in Toastmasters for one reason, maybe two reasons, to improve our leadership and to improve our communication. When I joined Toastmasters, actually I didn't really realize there was a leadership component. I didn't know anything about it. I was actually, it reminds me of Adela, your speech right now, talking about being a talent acquisition and I was in a position once where I was looking for a job, and it was a recruiter who actually said, "Great, go to Toastmasters, learn how to sell yourself more." I thought it was quite an interesting thing to do. Meanwhile, six years later, here I am. But I did not realize that there was a leadership component to Toastmasters. When you are encouraging people, you want to ensure that they are getting as money, I think, like to get their money's worth out of Toastmasters. And you want to try to ensure that they are getting their money's worth out of that. And part of that is listening and receiving evaluation, which is some meaning to it. Just like any good speech, and tie the end of the evaluation to the beginning. We've all heard a little bit about the sandwich technique, where you start on a positive note, you get some points for improvement, and then you end on a positive note. On one perspective, that is indeed tying the beginning in with the end. Summarize your key points. I like to think of what I heard, what I saw, what I felt. I like looking at evaluation from that perspective. I think because we are so used to the sandwich technique, nothing's wrong with the sandwich technique. However, I personally think that what I saw, what I heard, what I felt, perhaps brings a bit more of a feeling of emotion, of connection to the speech, versus perhaps a little bit more mathematical look at something from a sandwich perspective. Just my perspective. I managed to sneak in one, perhaps oblique, but some little story this evening about a personal experience. It's important to do that at least once. Any more than two times perhaps it gets a bit drawn out. However, I think it's important to do a personal story because it makes the individual receiving evaluation, yes, they can relate to what they're talking about.